morning, friends, and welcome to the finals hall here in Munich, Germany, for the first final of the day, 50-meter rifle prone men. I'm Hilary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having Italy's Olympic champion and Olympic silver medalist in 3P and 10-meter air rifle men, Niccolò Campriani. Thank you for being with us today, Nico. How are you doing?
Good morning, good morning. thank you. I'm fine.
Are you fine?
It's a little bit colder here, I guess. I was better in England, probably, where I'm studying.
That's pretty sad to say, because usually England is the one that everyone complains about the weather and everything. But here it has been absolutely freezing cold and rainy and windy, and it's just has not been a whole lot of fun for the athletes who have got to shoot outside. We've heard a bunch of complaints, but we can't do anything about it, unfortunately.
No, it's probably going to be really, really hot in Granada for the next World Cup. So
exactly.
I guess crazy
coming
weather.
Coming off of Fort Benning, where it was also even there, it was unseasonably cool in Fort Benning, and then coming here, I never had any idea that I would have had to bring a parka with me, and I didn't have a chance to do that. So I think we're all suffering in the cold. In just a second, I'm going to have a chance to go over our 8 finalists today. And then we can just go over quickly the new finals format. Just to keep in mind, all these 8 athletes after qualifications have entered into the final, and their qualification scores are erased, and they all start with 0, so it's a fair game for everybody.
And the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Olympic Shooting Range, Munich, the finals competition for the 50-meter rifle prone men event will now begin. It's my pleasure to introduce
on firing point H, representing Slovenia, we have Raymond DEBEVEC.
I mean, he's the legend of shooting a gold medal many, many years ago. He's still here, bronze medal last year, and he's 50. 1 month ago, he got his 50.
Unbelievable. On firing point G, representing Serbia, we have Nemanja Miroslavljev.
Another really good friend of mine, really good shooters, and he can make a final in every event, a rifle prone 3P. So hopefully we'll see him again on top of the podium or on the podium.
That would be great. On firing point F, representing Germany, we have Henry Junghanel.
Yeah, he's doing really, really good. I mean, he's, again, another of these guys that's studying United States with Kentucky University and just won 2 golds the first World Cup in Korea. He's doing really, really good.
On firing point E, representing Germany as well, we have Mike Eckhart.
Yeah, Mr. Eckhart, I mean, that's it. The average age in a prone final is this. You need to be expert, and especially in days like this with that kind of wind, you need to be an expert.
On firing point D, representing Italy, we have Marco Di Nicolo.
Well, I'll root for him, of course.
Of course.
he's my teammate, he's my roommate when we go to World Cup Olympic Village, and he just became a father a few months ago.
Congratulations. Wow. On firing point C, representing France, we have Mickael Dalouvan.
Yeah, I think he's the youngest shooter in the final. He did really good. It wasn't an easy day in the qualification round, and we'll see how he deals with the new final.
On firing point B, representing Austria, we have Thomas MATHIS.
Yeah, I shot many times against him as a junior. He's a really, really good sling shooter. Prone, kneeling, awesome shooter.
And on firing point A, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Young Chun Joy.
Well, Korea is probably the new country of shooting. They did extremely good at the last Olympics. They topped the medal rankings, and they always bring new people. I mean, I never heard of him, so
I never have either, so it's always interesting to see. You see that with China and also Korea, that people you've never seen before, they enter into a final, win the gold, and then you don't see them again.
Yeah, you know, they can do that. I mean, I've seen by mistake, I saw one of those national ranking in China. It's crazy.
Yeah.
It's probably even better than the World Cup. I mean, thank God we have only 2 Chinese at the Olympic Games, because it would be really, really hard otherwise. No, I mean, extremely good. It's, I guess they have a great school. I hope to actually to go there and train with them. I'm trying to organize a training camp, maybe 2-3 weeks in Beijing, training with the Chinese national team. Try to bring Petra, my girlfriend, with me, and I bet it's going to be an experience. I mean, I learned so much from the Americans, and I think this is my way of improving. I don't have really a coach. There is a national coach, Gabby Bullman, but honestly, I like to learn from other shooters, share different opinions, and see what the others do in order to deal with problems. It's really interesting.
That's great. Best of luck to you if they allow you in. You know, whenever I ask any of the Chinese shooters about what they do for training, they don't give away anything. It's a big secret.
Well, I mean,
which they should. You know, it works for them.
The language is a barrier too. Maybe it would be nice to talk to many of those shooters, but they really can't speak English. So
right.
We will see. We'll see. I mean, being there, I'll try to help, of course.
Yeah,
I mean,
of course.
Once I'm there,
they
I will
learn
share
a lot from
my
you.
Experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that was the deal with Americans as well. I learned a lot about shooting in prone when I was over there, about shooting in the wind. And I tried to help in standing. And for me, I mean, it was just amazing that a real friend like Emmons was on the podium with me at the Olympics. I mean, we all trained together. And honestly, at that point, it wasn't really about Italy versus United States.
No.
We really didn't care. I mean, we're just trying to
two brothers
to face.
On the podium.
And I mean, we both had nightmares as well. I mean, I had my last shot in Beijing. He had his last shot in Athens and Beijing. So we were trying to figure out maybe a solution for both of us that would work. And it was great. It was great to share that moment with him.
Let's talk about a little bit of what's going on in your life recently. What's happening with you?
I'm busy. I'm busy with school. Mm-hmm. I am finishing my master in sport engineering in England. Just finished my classes now, working on my thesis. And yeah, I mean, I took basically a year off from shooting. I've done a little bit of air rifle. So, for example, I shot at the European Championship and in Korea. But, I mean, I'm not training more than twice a week. And I just needed some time to to recharge my batteries, think about something else, and also figure out, you know, these new rules, it is a big change. And of course, there is still room for improvements. I really hope so. A lot of shooters are talking about how we can improve this format. We're still in a testing period. And we will see at the end of the year. Hopefully we will collect some feedbacks and give it to the athletes representative, and I'm sure the ISSF will listen to us and see how we can improve the sport in a better way altogether, of course.
Right. That's a great idea. And you're working on a project as well, is that right?
Yeah. I mean, that project is finished. I'm here in Munich because we present a new air rifle with Pardini. I mean, Pardini is famous for their pistol, and when I did my internship with them in 2010, I convinced them to produce an air rifle. So we kept it secret for a few years, and finally we're here to present it. Basically, I mean, I am a shooter, but the good thing is that I always travel around, I always share my experience with other shooters, so I knew what the shooters want, and the whole loading in position is going to be an advantage. So right now, you can't load an air rifle in position. You always have to use the stand in order to put the pellets. This time, it's going to be just like a small bore. So you stay in position, you settle down, and when you find the position, you just keep shooting. It's easier to keep the pace, and especially it's going to be a big help with this new final. Really fast, you know, three shots in under 50 seconds for a rifle. It is quite fast. So if you can stay in position, well, it is an advantage, and we'll see how it goes. I mean, I started using it 1 month ago, and it's good.
Good luck to you with that. That's great.
Thanks.
Let's take a look now. We've got the first series under our belt now. Debevec is holding on to first place, and he is holding on to that over De Nicolo and Jungenel, who are tied up in second place. They're only 0.3 of a point behind, and only 0.3 of a point behind De Nicolo and Jungenel, we have Mathis. It's a very, very tight final at the moment. We've got another series of three shots to go before we go into single shots. So, I mean, it's really anybody's game at this point.
Yeah, we see the three expert shooter right now in first, second, and third place. I'm happy to see Marco, and we'll see what happens. I mean, Jungenel, I think he's showing that he's probably one of the top three shooters in prone right now. I was pretty upset that he did not shoot at the Olympics last year. It's hard. I mean, they have trials and everything, so it's not easy for him. But he was definitely one of the top shooters last year, and I think he's taking his revenge.
He certainly is. I mean, he just has had a fantastic season so far. And I wish him the best and to keep up the good work. Now, Nico, how important are these first series that you shoot really well? I mean, is it hard to make up points if you don't start off well in the first two series?
Yeah. Well, we'll talk about it with the ISSF if maybe we could move the first elimination a little bit after, because right now, yeah, it is important. It's maybe too important, because a mistake in those six shots and you're out. You don't have time to catch up.
Right.
So we're just thinking, each shooter, is it enough to understand if you're a good shooter or not? Maybe you know, it's also a matter of chance. So we need to figure out the minimum number of shots. But yeah, it is quite stressful. You saw me this year. I struggled quite a lot, and it's a different kind of shooting. It's three shots in a group. It's a different skill set.
So let's take a look here. Mathis has now moved up into first place. He is only holding on to that by 0.4 of a point over De Nicolo. Debevec has moved down into third place. He's tied up now with Jungenell and only 0.4 of a point behind De Nicolo. Still, it's really, really close. We're going on to single shots now, and after these two shots, the first person will be eliminated, whoever's in eighth place. And right now that's being held by Choi from Korea. 1.1 of a point. Do you think he's got any future in staying into this final with just 1.1? He's...
Well, see, maybe for one position or two, but I mean, it's really hard to go back on the first few places. And I mean, I'm happy for Mathis. He's doing really good. I think Austria is quite lucky with these new shooters. Ungerang just won a gold a few days ago. Mathis is really young as well, so it's like a bright future for the Austrian shooting team.
Mathis is still holding on to first place. He's kind of pulled ahead a bit by 0.8 of a point now. De Nicolo still holding on to second place. And just 0.1 of a point behind De Nicolo, we've got Debevec. And Jungenell now is 0.3 of a point behind Debevec. Choi still is in eighth place, and he's 0.9 of a point behind Dalouin.
For the next competition shot, load. Start.
Here we go now, it's Choi. I mean, he's in trouble, and it's a really, really good shot. And I hope for a 9 of the other shooters, but
10.7,
it is,
not
it is
bad.
A good shot, yeah. And the 9 came as well. A few other shooters, we'll see what happens.
It's not going to be enough, unfortunately. We are going to have to say goodbye to Choi from Korea. Excellent final shot, but leaving just half a point behind Mirasaviev. We've got a tie now for first place between De Nicolo and Debevec. Mathis has moved down to third place. He's only 1/10 of a point behind the two, and Eckhart is 0.3 of a point behind Mathis.
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, we kind of see these with these new rules. It is a different skill set. Choi won the qualification round, and with this different kind of shooting, he just didn't handle the final. Now we will see. Marco is in the first place. I'm quite happy with that. But all the shooters are really, really close. So
really, it's anybody's game. This is the thing, you know. You have one bad shot, and you go right down into last place. You know, this is what makes it exciting for the spectators, but does make it really stressful for you shooters.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's hard. I mean, right now we're talking about World Cups. You can imagine in Rio, and there is an Olympic medal and everything. It is going to be stressful, and it is going to be important to get there with a good mental preparation.
We have DEBEVEC now, who's moved up into first place, overtaking Di Nicolo by 8/10 of a point. And we have a three-way tie for third place between Dalun Junganel and Miroslaviev. Mathis is holding on now to seventh place, only by 1/10 of a point. So it's really going to be down to this last shot to find out if he can stay in or if he's going to be eliminated.
I mean, DEBEVEC is amazing. I mean, he was shooter of the year, I think, in 91 or 92. And he shot the world record. He still has the world record in 3P in 91. And he's still there. it's just unbelievable. And we'll see what it's going to do. I mean, we're all halfway.
.10 for Mathis. That's the way you stay into the game, without a doubt. And in fact, Mathis has now moved up into second place. He was holding on by a thread there on seventh place. Unfortunately now, we're going to have to say goodbye to Miroslaviev. DEBEVEC still is holding on to first place. He's put a little bit of distance between himself and Mathis. He's 1.1 of a point ahead of Mathis. Dalouan is only 1/10 of a point behind and also tied up still. Three-way tie between Di Nicolo, Junganel, and Dalouan.
And, I mean, 1.1, that's good for DEBEVEC, especially with this kind of final. If you have an advantage, it's good for you, not just for the advantage, but you're just a little bit more relaxed.
That's right.
While all the other shooters right now, they know that if they shoot a 9, they might be out. So it's not definitely easy for them, but yeah.
And there you go, 9.9.
They got relaxed. He got relaxed as well.
So the highest score in that round was Di Nicolo with a 10.5.
So we now have Eckhart, who's holding on to the elimination position. Second place right now, we've got a tie for it with Di Nicolo and Mathis. DEBEVEC has eaten away a little bit at his lead. He's still ahead, though, by 6/10 of a point. One more shot to go to find out who is going to end up in sixth place.
For the next competition shot, low.
And we'll see which one of the German will stay in the game, if Junganel or Eckhart. Unfortunately, they have to fight against each other this time. Eckhart at 9.9.
That's not going to help out his situation here.
So we have our next
in fact, we are going to have to say goodbye to Mike Eckhart from Germany, finishing off in sixth place. Debevitz's lead is dwindling down. He's only ahead by 2/10 of a point. Di Nicolo is in second place, and 1/10 of a point behind him is Mathis. This is after Mathis shot a great 10.7. Di Nicolo, the highest score, 10.8.
Yeah, 21.3. Those two shots, that's really
good.
That's not bad. It's more than 10-6 average, so that was helpful. And now DEBEVEC is close again.
Wow, Dalouan, 10.8. In fact, DEBEVEC still in the lead by 2/10 of a point. We've got Junganel now 4/10 of a point behind and in fifth place. This is going to be the deciding shot for fifth place. And we know that Junganel definitely has it in him to shoot in the high tens, so we'll see if he can stay in the game.
Well, Harry can do it,
oh, God,
for sure.
Yeah.
He is one of the guys that can never shoot 10-7 or more if he wants. So it's up to him now. Well, another great shot.
Unbelievable.
From the shooter, the 9.
And a perfect 10.9 for Dalouan. Mathis, a 10.8. And with that 10.9, that's the way he climbed up the scoreboard. He has overtaken DEBEVEC. He's up by 0.2 of a point. And tied up with Debevec, we have Mathis.
French shooter shot 21.7. And I mean, the maximum is 21.8. It's 2 10.9. So amazing, amazing. Maybe if you shoot out advice, it's not as precise.
And in fact, we're going to have to say goodbye to Henry Jungenel from Germany. Fantastic shooter, great person. He's got a great future ahead of him, without a doubt. So this is kind of like the tight shot here. The next two shots are going to determine who's going to be going for the medals and who is going to be eliminated. And we have Dalouin in first place by 0.2 of a point.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys, but I had to root for Marco.
Of course.
So. Off. 9-9 for Marco.
For Marco. That puts him in fourth place. He's 1.2 of a point behind Debevec. Mathis is in first place by 0.3 of a point, followed by Dalouin. Debevec has now moved down into third place. He's down 0.3 of a point.
In fourth place now, behind by 1.2. We have five competition
shots. Well, it's quite nice to see that the two younger shooters are in the lead, especially in prone.
This is what we've been seeing a lot, Nico, is that the young ones that we haven't seen in finals before seem to be taking hold of the new finals format. And maybe it's just because they haven't shot in the old format or they're not used to it. I'm not quite sure, but we're seeing a lot of new faces on the podium.
I mean, we also have to remember that this is the year after the Olympics, so all of us, all the people that shot at the Olympics, we are all pretty tired.
Pretty tired, exactly.
And we needed a break as well. And of course, I mean, new ones, they're quite they're new at this sport. Of course, they shot in their national championship and everything, but they're, you know, they're hangry.
Yeah, they are.
They're hangry, they're hungry, and they're definitely really competitive.
So unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Marco De Nicolo from Italy, finishing off in fourth place. We've got Mathis in first place by 0.3 of a point over Dalouin. Debevec is in third place. He's 0.6 of a point down.
I'm just trying to figure out if I'm the young or the old right now.
Don't think about things like that.
Kind of in between, right?
Yes, you are.
Damn.
It just depends on how you feel.
Start.
Okay, we've got Debevec 0.6 of a point behind. Two shots to go to find out who's going to be going home with the bronze.
Another good shot for the French shooter. Mm-hmm. 10.4.
So an excellent.
It's great. Both 10-7.
Excellent job there. Mathis still in first place. And I'll tell you, the crowd here is rooting for him, without a doubt. We had singing going on the other day when the other Austrian won. It was great. We have Mathis ahead in 0.6 of a point. And Debevec is only 0.3 of a point behind. This is a shot that will tell us who's going to be going home with the bronze.
I don't want to go hard on Raymond, but I mean, Mathis is 22. French is 23, is 45 years old together. Still younger than him. All right, well, Raymond looks great. A lot of fitness. He does look 50.
Whoa, 10.8 for Dalouin. And that
Raymond
does it. Raymond is out. He's going home with the bronze medal.
Raymond Debevec.
So, really, congratulations to him. It's just amazing.
We've got two more shots to go for the gold. Here is our bronze medalist, Raymond Debevec.
10.8.
Now, this is the deal. We've got 1/10 of a point separating first and second place, Mathis from Dalouin. Who would you put your money on?
Well, I don't know the HALLUIN, honestly. I know Mathis is a really good guy. I trained with him in Innsbruck before the Olympics as well. I don't know. I mean, maybe Mathis?
10.5 for Dalouin. 10.2 for Mathis.
So you don't ask.
Let us change the scoreboard around a little bit here. We've got Dallouane, who has now overtaken Mathis by a mere 0.2 of a point. One more shot to decide the gold.
Look, I don't really know if it's an advantage or not, because it's always easier if you're behind, you know, mm-hmm. when, especially when the speaker says
exactly
you're leading.
Where you are.
You're leading and there is one shot to go. I don't know. I prefer to stay second and 1/10 behind, honestly. But that's me, right?
That's right. Everybody's
who knows?
Has individual ideas. Ooh, 9.9 for Dallouane. 10.0.
Well, not enough.
Unbelievable.
1/10 behind.
What's happened here?
We lost the ranking, but yeah, if the math is not an opinion, I think the French shooter should have won by 1/10. It was really, really close.
And just waiting for that confirmation.
The initial response from me was a win, but we need to wait for official results.
And there we go. Dallouane from France has won the gold medal by 1/10 of a point over Mathis. Great job for this young man, without a doubt. It'll be nice to see France on the highest step of the podium.
Once again, I mean, Strel'ba won last World Cup. And Mathis is happy too, of course. I mean, 1/10 is nothing.
It's
kind of
really
deserved the gold medal as well. So, and he knows that, so that's a good thing.
So Nico, thank you very much for joining me today. Good luck with your new project and this new rifle. I hope it all goes well for you.
Yeah. It's going to be good. It's new motivations, new Olympic cycle, new rules, new rifle, new everything. And yeah, so maybe I don't feel that old.
Good.
Ceremony for the 50-meter rifle men's event will now take place. The medals will be presented by Mr. Tomislav Sepic, Chairman of the Rifle Committee and member of the ISSF Administrative Council. Your bronze medalist, representing Slovenia, Rajmond DEBEVEC. Your silver medalist, representing Austria, Thomas Mathis. And your gold medalist, representing France, Mickael Dallouane. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of France.